Tranquille peinard, hein, toi.
C'est ça. Elle est belle, la vie. Salut à tous. Et donc, comme vous aurez pu le voir, nous sommes au Theater of the Sea ce matin. Parce qu'on va nager avec les dauphins. Cache ta joie. On est fatigué, hein. Vous pourrez sûrement le voir sur ma tête, moi je le vois pas à l'écran. Mais... on s'est pressé pour arriver ici parce que normalement on avait rendez-vous pour aller nager avec les dauphins à 10h. Et arrivé ici, on nous a dit qu'en fait c'était pour 12h50. Donc on va aller faire un petit tour. Ils sont là. On va aller faire un petit tour. Comme ça on peut voir un peu ce qu'il y a. C'était pas prévu, mais bon, on va s'occuper un peu. Et puis on va filmer un peu tout ça. Et puis Chris, normalement, a la GoPro pour filmer les dauphins, si on sait le faire. Et voilà. Et puis après on se mettra en route pour la villa. Et en attendant, regardez-moi ça. Il est où? Il est là. Aïe. Il a plongé.
Il est plus là.
Il a plongé, il est plus là. Il est là, il est là.
Bon, il est gros celui-là, c'est pas le même.
Je crois que les bassins sont séparés. Ah, tu crois qu'il y en a plusieurs dans le bassin? Ah oui, en effet.
Oui, s'il y en a un, il est clairement plus gros que l'autre.
C'est celui-là qui dit hello.
Bra.
Hello.
Hello. Bra. Bra.
Hello.
Il ne dit plus maintenant.
Bra.
C'est le mot.
Oh putain. Là. Bonjour.
Hello. 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 Hello.
Mais il est gros bébé. Mais oui, moi c'est un gros bébé. Mais c'est un... Oui, moi j'ai une feuille. Il mange une feuille.
Alex?
to go, some of the most colorful, charismatic, and some of the most intelligent animals on the planet. Parrots are actually tied at the top of the avian intelligence scale with the corvid family. So think of jays, magpies, ravens, and crows. Some scientists compare their intelligence to that of the average human toddler, aged between 2 and 4. And here at Theater C, we love working with this level of intelligence, whether it be through training or even playing games, which are very enriching as well as stimulating for our birds. So I'm going to introduce you folks to our first game. Now this is the Psychologist's Color Form game. Now I know at first glance it does look like a playground. You're not wrong. I can promise you it's a little more scientific than that. Psychologists developed boards like these in order to test the IQs of the average preschoolers. You'll notice we have 3 individual shapes with their individual colors. We have a red square, a yellow star, a blue circle, and then of course all of the corresponding holes in which they go. I'm going to see if my buddy Ziggy would like to join me because he looks like he might jump clean out of his feathers if I don't kick him.
He's drinking.
You're so weird. Alright folks, this is Ziggy. Ziggy is our 23-year-old scarlet macaw. And the other thing about Ziggy is he's still pretty new to this game. He's actually been doing a lot better. So I'm very proud of him. Parrots love a lot of noise. The louder you are, the happier he's going to be. So when he happens to get something right, he's sure to stop and keep clapping your hands and tell him he's the best rainbow chicken you've ever seen in your entire life. For the first round, we'll start off really simple, one piece at a time in order. Let's start with his favorite, the red square. Next is the yellow star, a little more difficult because of all these edges. We have fingers and wrists to twist it and turn it, but look what he can accomplish with just a piece. Last but not least, folks, blue circle and only one spot remaining. That's a good one. Leave me one second. who beats Pack-a-Punch. They have upwards of 500 pounds of pressure, rolling into 1,200 pounds of pressure in Harley Davidson. And it only goes up from there. The Palm Cockatoo of Australia, 1,500 pounds of pressure in a week alone. So it's actually a pretty good idea not to try to pick a pet or feed a parrot if you don't know, because it only takes 12 pounds of pressure to completely take off your finger. But that being said, since I did just bleach the stage, instead of using somebody's finger I'm going to use a macadamia nut. If you're familiar with these, we need hammers to open these. Anything that will give us 300 to 500 pounds of pressure just to crack open. Makaya has 1,200 pounds of pressure in her beak. Hyacinths are one of the largest known species of parrots, and they're the only ones that can consistently crack Max open with no effort. What you'll notice is she just cracked it completely in half, instead of just crushing the shell to get to the good stuff. This way, she gets the entire magnet out, and she can use the other half of that really, really thick shell to actually trim down her ever so lovely beak. While she enjoys her snack, I'm gonna head back over here to Ziggy so he can practice tossing out that second physical feature for you folks. It is little short legs! You did it, baby! You did it! Let's see if Avril, you wanna try? You can practice it, and we'll show everybody. Good boy! That was perfect. Thank you, little short legs. So, short legs are a necessity for parrots because they don't run. They definitely don't swim. They perch and they climb. Having this low center of gravity is perfect in order for them to stay balanced on all different sizes of branches and perches, as well as in the waters like mine. Also, Aza, bless you. To be extremely acrobatic, Ziggy and Admiral are so happy to show you their cute little flips. You'll also notice when Makaya does flips, parrots can use their beak as an extra appendage. Their legs are also the perfect length for them to hold things up to their beaks to eat, manipulate, use tools, or even scratch those really good spots behind their head. For the third and final physical characteristic, I'm actually going to walk around with my buddy Clover. Do me a favor, folks. Don't make fun of his fuzzy pants. Don't yank on his tail feathers. I just want you to admire his absolutely incredible, awkward-looking feet. Look at him. He has two toes that are pointing forward and two toes that are pointing backwards. So this is what we call zygodactyl feet. I know it sounds like the name of a dinosaur or something that I'm just making up, but I promise it's just a special term for a very special type of foot that is actually incredibly rare in the bird world. Out of 10,000 different bird species, very few actually have this specialized perching foot, which does include our parrot friends, toucans, woodpeckers, and roadrunners. So the advantages to having zygodactyl feet, as opposed to the traditional perching foot, which you will notice from our cleanup crew, we have Spot and Alfalfa, because he has a wonky foot. Anyway, those little red-winged blackbirds, they have the traditional perching foot. Three toes forward, one toe back. But zygodactyl feet give these types of birds wide, firm bases in order to grip everything. They're also incredibly dexterous. They use their feet the way we use our hands. So how we would take an apple and hold it up to their mouth, they take food and hold it up to their mouths. And Clover here is pretty special because he's learned to use a combination of his zygodactyl feet and his short legs in a way that's actually incredibly challenging for parrots. Let's take him a stroll on his favorite blue barrel. But first, I think he might want to introduce himself. What do you think, Bubba? You want to say hello? Hello? One more? Good boy. Even though your breath smells like Brussels sprouts, I still love you. First things first, short legs. They give him that perfect and necessary low center of gravity to keep him balanced, standing upright on the barrel. Combined with his perfect zygodactyl feet, giving him that nice, wide, firm base in order to keep a very steady grip on it. Try to imagine a longer-legged type of bird, like a flamingo. They have very long legs, webbed feet.
This is Nicole, and along with Angela, we'll be the trainers for your show today. But more importantly, how about a round of applause for your real stars, Sherman and Kivett?
Qu'on est mouillé.
On est tous deux Beach of the Lagoon. Et Chris, il prend un miam. Ça, c'est Chris. Ça, c'est le miam. Attends. Et Chris, il va balancer dans la flotte. Mais t'as rien balancé! Comment tu les as trollés? C'est pas censé être pour les poissons. Noémie va faire un quarter aussi.
Ça, je connais des quarterbacks.
Noémie fera-t-elle mieux ça que Chris?
J'ai fait ça bien moi.
Oh, le bleu il est beau. Le poisson, il l'a attrapé au vol, hein.
Deux fois.
Il faut s'approcher comme si on tenait un bébé géant. Plus bas, je crois. Plus.
Alright, here she comes this time for real. Underneath, guys. Good.
On fait les essais avec les jambes. Hein.
And smile. You guys can let her go.
Je sais pas si je t'ai eu quoi parce que comme c'était sur ma tête.
Tu veux t'asseoir?
Non, non, non.
T'as relancé la caméra?
Ouais.
Got you!
moi et la fille.
Donc Nikki est en train de me draguer.
Il y en a une des deux qui en a 35 et l'autre en a 5.
Je dirais que 35, ça doit être celle qui a le... celle qui a la nageoire cassée et la plus grande accessoirement. Si, si, si.
And you guys can rub her side. You can slow down.
Oh, Dieu, Dieu, t'es trop gentil, toi. C'est un gentil dauphin.
What do you guys think it feels like?
It feels like plastic.
Like a wet hot dog? Yeah. You got a sneaky rub over there.
Et moi, j'en ai pas droit. Ils sont en train de coller les oiseaux. Où tu vas? Bah, on la caresse pas.
Donc... baby. You guys can go ahead and let her go. I'm gonna turn her around. Yeah, you did it, but you weren't shaking your head now. Okay, you guys can rub the belly.
C'est pas la même chose. Hein.
Now we're up close and personal.
Okay. Oh,
alright, guys, I'm gonna let her know. Good job. But she did great.
Trop chaud, trop chaud, trop chaud.